Hello, hello, and happy Wednesday. Welcome to the Creative Classroom, and welcome to day three of spring crafting. We're coming to you every morning this week just to share a little crafting inspiration. Hopefully it puts a smile on your face. So I'm here, like I said, in the Creative Classroom, but I'm not alone. An appropriate distance away, I have two people with me. Let's talk about my moderator first. Say hi to Nicole.
Hello.
If you watched yesterday, you noticed that we've switched spots now. Yesterday, Nicole demoed and I moderated. And moderating is just really all about answering your questions on this Facebook Live, whether you're watching on our Spellbinders channel or Fun Stamper's Journey. Interact. Leave posts, leave questions, leave comments, just whatever tickles your fancy. And, of course, we've also got our guru of all things video, and that is Mr. Roy. So we can say hi to Roy. And you can see a shot maybe of our studio, because that's always fun to see the behind-the-scenes things going on. Mm. Woo! That shot is, you can tell how bright these lights are on me over here. I've got to, like, blast it out. But in any case, welcome. I have got a fun card set to share with you today. I'm going to share basically the same technique shown with three different colorways, and I'm going to make like a set of cards. I love doing sets of cards because once you're in a roll and once you're into it, you might as well just do multiples. And this particular set is pretty special, I think, because it's all about being grateful and thankful. And in this time right now, there are plenty of things to be grateful for and plenty of people you probably want to say thank you for. You know, whether it's healthcare workers or someone's done a great favor for you. And maybe if you don't have anyone in particular to give them to, just make a set of cards and plan on having them in your stash or delivering them. I know there are lots of organizations out there that will take cards like this and pass them out to the people who need them most. So I've got three different envelopes right here already. I'm going to just sneak peek my color palette right here. Now I created these envelopes with our scoring board, and it's just taking a piece of our cardstock. And that's what I love about making my own envelopes, is that these are going to perfectly coordinate with my cards. So these are three of the colorways I'm going to be working with. And the other thing I'm going to be working with today is liquid color. Now, because I am doing liquid color, I've got our color splash sheets right here. And so these are a little bit heavier. They're watercolor paper, which you probably can't really tell in the video, but they are definitely a sturdier, heavier paper, and they've got the watercolor effect to them. So they're going to be perfect for these liquid colors. Now, the first set of three colors, I've picked three different sets of three, and I'll be walking all three of them through for you. This one is banana cream, so a lighter yellow, lemon drop, and orange creamsicle. And I'm going to bring one of my color splash sheets in. And this is really a fun technique. I've shown a slight variety on this technique before, but this one's going to be a little bit different. I've showed this, again, something similar, but with regular cardstock, but the watercolor paper is really fun and really special. So let's start out with our lightest color, which oddly enough is going to go in the middle of my card panel here. So I'm just squirting it on a clear block. You can use a clear plastic sheet. You could use a non-porous surface, whatever you have handy. And then I'm picking it up with one of our daubers. These are our larger daubers, which work perfectly. And I do keep these quarantined from my regular ink daubers. So let me just talk a minute about liquid color. It's pretty special. It's a dye ink, whereas our normal ink pads are a hybrid ink. So they would be a combination of pigment and dye. And so they do work for this technique, but not as well as this dye ink. This dye ink reacts with water, so that makes it perfect for what I'm going to show you. So again, you're going to drop it on here. And I do, like I said, keep these daubers separate from my ink daubers. I just have them in a different little bin. Then I always know that they're perfect for liquid colors, and I can use them over and over again. So as you can see, the sponge dauber just soaks up that liquid color. There's virtually nothing left on there. And I'm going to come into the middle of my card panel. So I'm going to be blending these a little bit. So I want my lightest color to be in the middle, just so I can come back and then add two darker shades, top and bottom. Now, if this wasn't all the way gone, pretty much, I could wipe it off with a paper towel, but I'm just going to go right into my lemon drop, which is my next darker color. And this really goes a long way. You don't have to do squirt too much on there. It's probably about the size, between a dime and a quarter. So I'm going to bring my lemon drop on top. And you notice that even though this is watercolor paper, I did not wet this paper or anything in advance. This is going straight to dry splash sheet. So I want to get lots of rich color on there. You can see that's a little bit brighter than my banana cream, so it does blend really nice. And last of all, I'm going to do my orange creamsicle. Kind of thought this looked a little bit like a sunset-ish, maybe, color palette. But what's awesome about our liquid colors is there's so many different choices. You could come up with your own color combo, and it would be amazing. So again, orange creamsicle coming in. Notice how I started at the bottom and kind of brought it in. Making sure I'm picking up all that color. And then it just kind of blends in. So, really fun, super easy. Now, if you were doing this ink technique with other types of inks, I know probably a lot of you have like the distress inks out there and stuff, and this works perfectly for that too, but you will be spending a lot more time blending, 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 blending. It's fabulous, but what I love about this is it's so quick. See how I laid all that color down? It virtually took mere minutes. All right, so I'm gonna grab one of our stencils. Actually, I'm gonna bring our catalog in super quick. Miss Nicole,
yes.
I know that this technique works great for all of our stencils. Could we put a link for like the whole stencil category or just individual stencils?
We can do that. Yeah? Totally, we can do that, yeah.
Cool, yeah. Because these are some of the stencils we've had in our past catalog, mm-hmm. but we have more new ones now. So this just gives you a quick peek at just the huge variety of stencils we have. These are kind of cool because they're 8.5 by 11, so you get like 4 different panels in one stencil. Most of them over here are 6 by 6 inches, which is what I am using today. So like I said, this is a new one, which wasn't in that catalog shot. This is called Cane Weave. Can you guess why? Probably because it looks like a basket weave, right? Super fun.
And is now a good time to say we have more stencils coming and upcoming releases?
Oh, Nicole, are you sharing a little sneak peek?
Oh, I didn't think I was supposed to say that. Oh,
actually, we don't have anything to show for a sneak peek, but
no, they're coming though.
It is true. We are developing new stencils right now because just lately, I don't know, we can't get enough of our stencils.
They're fun.
They're so fun. Okay, so I'm using a little bit of our electric tape, which is just kind of it's not really a washi tape. It's more of a post-it note, but it's going to hold my stencil down perfectly. And I just place that right over my inked panel. And this ink panel, I didn't wait for it to dry. I didn't heat set it. I didn't do anything like that. Most of that color is soaked into the splash sheet, but I don't worry about that. Now I'm coming in with one of our media misters, and this is just plain water in here, nothing super special. So I'm just gonna take it and give my watercolor paper a really nice spritz. And this splash sheet can hold quite a bit of water, so I'm laying a decent amount of water on there. And then I am just gonna let it soak in for a minute. And while I do that, I'm gonna move this color palette and bring in my next one, get it all prepped up. While that's soaking, I'll share the next colors I'm going to use. I'm gonna use Lavender Fusion, Lovely Blue, and Watermelon. So kind of a fun purple, pink, blue combo.
Reagan, we call these unicorn colors.
Unicorn mm-hmm. colors, I mm-hmm. like that. All right, so I think this is soaked in enough. Let's take a little reveal shot here.
Drum roll. Here we go.
Oh, this color combo doesn't show as much until it dries.
You can see a little though.
Yeah, you can see a little. I'm gonna bring in the dry one. The other two colors show up more dramatically. I could have done the other ones better, but oh, I guess I turned this upside down. So see how when it dries, it definitely shows up the pattern more. All right, we'll have more of an aha moment with my next color palette, I promise. So I'm gonna let this one dry. This one, like I said, I did dry earlier and I put on my Lemon Drop card base, so we'll set those aside, let that guy dry. All right, let's do a more Drama Mama one. Move those guys. Nope, that's my other one. Pink and purple, let's do it. Again, starting with my lightest color. I absolutely love the stencil we're using on this one, too. So you guys leave a comment if you have ever used stencils on your crafting projects. And it doesn't have to be this type of technique, but any type of technique. They're really fun to use with modeling paste. They're actually super fun with the gel press, too, if you guys have the gel press.
We should do some more of those vids.
We should do a gel press vid. That's so fun. Mm-hmm. We did ask yesterday for you guys to leave notes on what you want to see. So we'll have to add that one to the stack.
For sure.
All right, so we've got our lavender fusion now. So you can tell already this is darker, so it's going to show the watermark effect even better.
In the spirit of unicorns, Kim.
Yes.
What do unicorns eat for breakfast?
What do unicorns eat for breakfast? Sprinkles.
Lucky Charms.
Lucky Charms.
I'm stretching here. There aren't really a lot of good unicorn jokes out there.
Well, I have to say that my next color palette that I'm going to use, we were kind of joking around yesterday that we felt bad we didn't have a green project. My next color palette is going to have green.
Okay. I'll
so I feel like it might be kind of lucky. Hopefully.
I did show Reagan the video yesterday.
Yeah.
Showing her thing, and she was tickled. So that was a good win. It was a good mommy
little
win.
Cute thing showed up on there. I love that. All right. So this time I am bringing in one of our stencils, and this is, which one is this called? Quiz,
oh,
Nicole.
Oh, gosh. You have the catalog, you cheater. is that this? No? Is that this?
Yeah, you almost said it.
Cement tile?
No, cement tile I'm going to use
stained
next.
Glass.
Stained glass.
Stained glass.
Which it does look like stained glass.
I'm totally cheating. I'm looking at the website, by the way.
All right. So taping that down, and hopefully this one will be, I know I did this one earlier. It does show up really nicely. So again, just bringing in my water. And I did want to share a few different colors because I think that it just gives you some different ideas. All right, we'll let that set for a minute. I like to let it set so I don't, like, pull the stencil up too quickly. But check out my next color combo I'm going to do real quickly. We've got Turbo Teal, Limeade Splash, and Cool Pool.
Love it.
So these, what do these feel like? Summery colors? I don't know. But anyway, I love the green because that's going to give us our lucky green.
This is such a cool technique because you literally can do it.
It's so fast, right?
Any colors, and it's such a wow factor.
Like I said, you can also.
Oh, yeah, that one was a wow.
Isn't that one fun?
Yeah.
So right away, you can just see that bam, 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 the stained glass shows up. You can do, like I said, let this air dry or accelerate the drying with a heat tool, in which case you would be making these cards lickety-split. And like I said, once you're creating kind of a mess, just go for it. Do like all the different color combos.
Totally.
All the ones you could think of. All right. I'm starting with my lightest color again, my Cool Pool.
You know what's fun is I actually haven't seen the finished projects here, so I'm kind of awaiting the
You're like, ooh.
The aha too. Yeah.
Now, Limeade and Turbo Teal are about the same vibrant color, palette, hue. Doesn't really matter which one you do first. Love the light. Love how it blends with the Cool Pool, though. Cool Pool is one of those colors that's like, hey, I'm happy with everybody. I just blend and be pals with everybody.
It's cool. It's a cool friend.
Cool, get it?
Get it.
Okay, so Turbo Teal on the top. Again, another one of our favorites in the color palette. I mean, actually, this feels even more vibrant than the last one, so I'm excited to see the aha. And if the other palette was unicorn, what is this? Reagan would say it's...
Oh, gosh, you put me on the spot here. I got nothing. I got nothing.
Mermaid!
Oh, duh.
Doesn't it kind of feel like mermaid?
You know, I think
kind of ocean-y?
Yeah, it totally is. Her mermaid vibes have a little bit of purple in them, too. So,
oh, I
but
suppose.
It totally is mermaid.
Purple
this
or
is very
pink.
Jane. This is very Jane mermaid, yeah?
Yeah.
I like it. That's really pretty. This might be my favorite.
And this is probably one of my favorite stencils, too, so this is a win-win right here. This is the cement tile. That's what Nicole guessed a minute ago.
Yep.
Absolutely love this. It's just got that vibe right now that's super trendy with all the patterns of the cement tile. In fact, we did a really cool pattern of cement tile on our pool project, which I'm excited. I was sharing around the office yesterday that our pool has been in the works for quite a few months because it's been one of these, like, we're contracting it ourselves, you know, blah, blah, blah. Which means it just goes slower. But we got it plastered yesterday. So all that's left is to, they're going to do a little cleanup, a little acid wash, and we fill it with water just in time for the Arizona heat.
Yay.
So as long as we're all self-quarantined, we might as well stay at home and swim in our pool, right?
Might as well. Mm-hmm. Oh, I know we were kind of saying, being in Arizona, it's not a bad place to be, you know, what do they call it, self-isolation
right.
or whatever.
Because they're saying you can get out and hike and, you know, mm-hmm. just don't be around a bunch of people. Like,
yeah.
And there are so many trails here in Arizona, even right in the Phoenix area, that you could get out and virtually not see anyone.
Yeah.
Maybe like one person walking their dog,
it's
you know?
True. Yep.
So we have plenty of places to go and people to
avoid.
Well, yeah, people to avoid. But, you know, you could go with your family. They said that's okay.
Yeah. Al Reagan, though, did say the other day, she was in the other room when I got home, and I said, Riggs, come hang out there. She goes, no, got to isolate. Like, honey, if you got it, we all have it. So
those of us who have kids, especially mine, is more getting in that tween age. And Jen, our photographer, is here today doing some shots for us, and she said, I don't think I want kids anymore. She's got teenagers, full-on teenagers. So look at that.
Beautiful.
How pretty, right? And definitely as it dries, this pops even more. So love how the liquid color reacts. So we're going to bring in some dry panels. Actually, let me just scooch this paper so I don't get my finished projects inky. Recycle that a little bit more. So this one I already shared with you, and we've got the lemon drop matching envelope. Love that. And now we need a sentiment. So I thought, you know what? I'm going to bring in some glimmer because, like Nicole had mentioned earlier, we're just kind of glimmer crazy around here. I do keep my glimmer in these FSJ storage pouches. I think that's really cool. Sometimes I put the packaging in here. I don't have that in this case, but this is one of our glimmer sentiments. And another quiz for Nicole is that this is the newer one. More sentiments?
More sentiments.
More sentiments.
Very creative with our names around here. But
this
what?
Does have tons
you know
it in it.
Mm-hmm.
It's got all the fun things. And actually, I did glimmer these already. We promised we're going to do glimmer one of these days on a live. But I love that this little die comes with it, too. And look how this cuts them out. Is this not fabulous? Maybe we can come in, like, super close to where I'm going to adhere this on. But it gives this great little border. And I love it. Just that extra little detail. And that die does come with a glimmer plate. So that's awesome. I'm using some white liner because I want to come in here real skinny with this one. And the white liner fits perfectly. And we also love the little bent piercer for doing the adhesive, especially on the white liner. I'm going to trim these ends real quick. Peel off this back end, especially good for those of us who like have no fingernails. Now I could come, you know, I could come anywhere in the card, dead center. I kind of like it where it's not quite centered. I think I'm going to do this one a little bit lower. And I did trim this one earlier. My next two I don't have trimmed. So I'll show you how to do that as we assemble it. But really, how simple, how sweet. And, oh, I forgot to tell you the foil color. So that was part of my story. So I love the glimmer plates, but check it out. We have black foil. Now this is so cool, and this really makes my kind of traditionally stamper heart happy because I do feel like it mimics a little bit just a traditional stamped image, but it's really got that extra little gloss and that extra little gleam that you can't really get from, you know, just a stamped image. And it's really fine, it's gorgeous. And it even has a little bit of a emboss, if you could see it in real life, I guess. Ooh, Roy's getting nice and close, I like it. So the sentiments are just stunning. They work perfectly no matter what, but I do want to point out the black foil because I think it doesn't get enough love, the black foil. Okay, so here's my next panel. This is the one that's dry. Oh my gosh, how beautiful, right, when it's dry? So loved this sentiment. I'm using all the thank yous, like I said. Of course, you could use any sentiments, birthdays, anniversaries, anything for this card process, but I'm kind of going with the grateful ones. And you can see that this die cut's a really nice long one, so if you were doing, you know, a card in the other direction, it would be plenty long.
So, Kim, I have an idea for something that I need to learn, and I guess I could just go here. Ask you to show me in the craft room, but I have never created my own envelopes with that scoring tool, the scoring board.
Ah, okay.
And I think that might be a fun little quickie, maybe? I don't know. Maybe I'm the only one. I don't know. You guys tell me if you guys know how to do it. I've never done it, but I keep seeing them, and they're so fun.
They actually are so easy, and what I love about our scoring tool, and we're definitely going to have to bring that in here, is that you only have to measure one measurement. Like, you think that this envelope looks super complicated. I'm putting a lot of adhesive because even though this is fairly flat, I don't want it to warp or anything. Check this out on the cool pool card base. I love it.
I like that one. That's pretty.
I do think that's my favorite.
I know.
Let me show you the envelope super quick.
I know. I'm trying to decide my favorite.
This envelope is an 8x8 piece of paper. That's what it starts out of. And you only have to do one measurement. And then the tool is so cool. It's such that you just rotate your 8x8 panel. And you get all your score lines, and bam, you fold it up, and I'm not kidding, it's so easy. So yes, awesome idea. And I love that the envelopes just match. I mean, so I'm cute. All about coordination. So two for two, let's show one more super fast. Okay, look how pretty this one when it's dry.
It's cool too.
Oh my gosh. So this is our unicorn one, I guess, according to Reagan. And it does have a pretty cute sentiment, which sort of goes with that theme. Come on, white liner, peel up. A really big thank you, right? So cute. So I think I'll do, actually, I'm going to do this one kind of in the middle. I like it. Right in that blue. I do like to kind of put them on my card first, because then I can try to center my sentiment, you know, when it's on that strip. Is that straight? I guess it's straight. Then you can always trim the extra away. And of course, we have our watermelon envelope. I'll just kind of tuck it in here. And how fun. So when you are doing your cards, and whether it's you're doing card sets, this would even be an awesome gift, actually, as a card set together. But whether you're doing them for yourself or to give them away, do include an envelope. I think it's so fun because cards are meant to be sent, guys. I know we love creating them and we love collecting them and putting them in our craft room. At least I do. But really consider sending them, especially nowadays. I think people could use that little extra touch base with someone, and how fun. I know I love getting cards in the mail. If I get one in the mail, I'm just like, what? It's so fun. So please do get your stamps out, address those envelopes, send them to people who need them, someone you just want to touch base with. So this will be my quiz. Nicole, think about who you'd send a card to, and Roy, think about who you'd send a card to. Mm-hmm. And ready, go.
Me?
Who's first?
You want me first?
Go ahead.
I'll do Roy first.
My daughter? I don't know.
Oh, that's cute. How fun. Oh, that would be unexpected.
Kids love card.
And if Dad sent one in the mail, she would freak out. That'd be so cool.
For sure.
Okay,
well,
Nicole.
I would definitely send one to my grandparents. They are what you would consider high risk, I guess.
Oh,
so
sure.
They are in complete isolation on the farm up in Washington.
Oh,
so,
that's kind of a hot spot, too.
It is. I will tell you one quick story. A few years ago, I didn't have time to make Mother's Day cards for my grandma and for the family, and I went to the store and bought them. And she basically said, don't ever do that again.
Oh!
I'd rather not get a card than get one of these store-bought things.
She'd rather have it late.
So my grandma saves them all. She appreciates them. And for that reason, I love to make them for her. So if you're watching, Grandma, I love you. You guys stay safe.
Oh, that's very special. And I would send one to my daughter in California. I am lucky enough to have all my kids living in town except for one daughter in California. So I think that I will send a card to her very soon. So leave a note in the comments who you'd send a card to. We very much appreciate you guys coming in. We will be back tomorrow morning.
Mm-hmm.
Well, I don't know who will be behind the desk here. You'll have to wait and see. It'll be a little surprise, I think. So in the meantime, have a great time. Check out our website at spellbinderspaperarts.com. And check out our blog there, too. There's so much good inspiration there. You guys will not be lacking inspiration, that's for sure. In the meantime, enjoy bringing paper to life.